appreciate your patience.
Thank you. Hi, I'm Nancy Hoebelheinrich, coming from Knowledge Motifs LLC out of San Mateo, California. And what I wanted to talk today to you today about was the Data Management Training Clearinghouse that is hosted at ESIP, but is a collaborative clearinghouse, essentially, or a metadata registry on resources. And to give it a context, what we've been talking about today is are all issues related to research data management in some way. One could take it that way. And part of what we're trying to do here, I think, with all of these different tools that we've been seeing and the changes to data so that it's reproducible, making those kinds of things available, is really a way of changing the culture of data management. So what I'm suggesting that we can do with something like a clearinghouse is to really add to that culture, change that culture by adding to something like a clearinghouse, which is in the commons. All right, so what is the commons? What's the idea of a commons? This commons is really from the definition from the digital library of the commons is that it's a term for shared resources in which each stakeholder has an equal interest. So when you're talking about educational resources, something that you're trying to offer to people either as a person who is supporting researchers or somebody who is actually creating data and wants to do it in a way that is either easier to make the data faster, you know, there are all kinds of motivations for working together and to changing the culture and making science better. So the idea of the commons is a way to make that happen. So one of the ways that I'm suggesting that this can be done is by adding to this commons and using a crowdsourced clearinghouse. So what is that? Tomorrow I'm doing PowerPoints and not PDF. This is much better. I didn't realize this. So what is it? What is it? Why is it? Where did it come from? What's it about? It's, as I said, a metadata registry for educational resources on research data management. It's the capabilities include searching resources, browsing, and submitting them. So anyone who can get an ESIP account, which is a free account, can submit learning resources to the clearinghouse. It uses a schema.org endorsed metadata scheme, the LRMI metadata scheme that's now maintained by Dublin Core. So it's focused on providing metadata that people can find on the web, you know, using Google and Yahoo and Yandex, you know, all those search engines should be able to find the resources that are available as well as on the clearinghouse itself. So that's the idea of it. The kinds of resources it contains include short courses, such as those from the Khan Academy, 7 to 15 minute modules, videos, different learning activities, presentations and webinars, something called data recipes that NASA creates, and then syllabi and curricula. So I think from the point of view, what I wanted to show, there is the URL there. I'm going to go through a little bit more about the background of it, and then I can really see some opportunities here where this could really be useful for this group. I wanted to talk about that a little bit. The use case behind this is that a number of people initially associated with the ESIP Federation. How many people know about the ESIP Federation? Do people know what that is, more or less? It's a membership organization of earth science partners of different kinds. So that includes software developers and educators and federal agencies and all kinds of organizations that are involved in making data matter is what the motto is. And it's a way to come together and work on problems that are common problems with solutions that they can develop. It's a very dynamic organization, a very interesting one in the terms of the problems that come up and the ways the problems are solved and so on. At any rate, so some of the members that are part of this particular effort that are part of ESIP were, besides, you know, individual organizations and federal agencies, USGS, DataONE, software, data carpentry, and people like that. So as all those folks are involved as part of their efforts into teaching about data management, research data management. And as we came together and started talking about this, we were trying to figure out what the main problem was. And essentially the main problem is that researchers want to learn about data management when they need to, in ways that are flexible and usable in different environments, but also data professionals need to know where there are different kinds of resources that they can either use or they, when they create them, they can offer them up to other people. So the idea was to pull these kinds of things together in the one venue, the clearinghouse venue, if at all possible. Other kinds of questions the researchers were asking is whether, you know, do they pertain to my subject domain? You know, I don't want to learn about something that I have no idea what it has to do with. I want examples from my different domain. Do they fit, if there's a data management framework that you know, my organization is using, for instance, USGS has a science support framework that everything that they teach about data management needs to fit that framework, and it's essentially a way of looking at the research data lifecycle. So they've got one, DataONE has a research lifecycle, you know, DCC, the Digital Curation Center, has another one. You know, people are interested in learning that language so that they, when they talk to their colleagues or their organizations, they're using the same terms for similar activities. And then, you know, are they available when I need them? What do they cost? These are some of the, sort of the key questions that people were asking. So the idea was to try to bring these all together when possible into a central clearinghouse. So these are the original collaborators, as you can see here, USGS, ESIP, DataONE, and then Data and Software Carpentry. We got a little bit of money from USGS, bless their hearts, to get it started for 6 months. And so we've got it implemented and started. It's maintained on the ESIP Commons, ESIP Federation Commons, which is now a Drupal-based content management system. You do need the free ESIP account, which you get at login if you don't have an account and you log in. And then the sustainability plan of it at this point is to do more crowdsourcing. So it's kind of based on the Wikipedia concept, you know, people contributing, but also having reviewers and editors, especially domain-specific editors who really know their stuff, coming in and, you know, either helping to augment metadata, because a lot of people just want to put the key information in and don't want to do all of it or don't know how to answer the questions related to, especially the educational metadata. And then, so in keeping that alive and going. We're at the point where it was initially launched in October of last year. So we've got some resources in it. We're looking to add more. We're looking for user feedback on the interface and the functionality in order to, we know already that there are things that we, you know, can't do and want to do. So we need to get the feedback and prioritize what those are. And then we're seeking funding for that enhancement. So the kinds of things I was thinking about as we've been talking about today,
So does somebody want to back to join as an editor? So you have a process?
Yeah, that's where, see the join where I am right here. There's a work. I was going to get to that in a second. I'll take you. That's right. So there's a working group through ESIP that you can join if you want to, and just to hear what, you know, what's going on with it, and then data management training topics in general. You can contact me, my colleague Sophie Howe at UCAR is also part of it. There's a group that's working with it, and that's the picture of the first interface. But what I wanted to talk about just briefly, as I was listening today, you know, a lot of times there have been presentations about different kinds of tools and different kinds of websites. And of course, this is not designed to be something that would be advertising those resources. But if there's something that, if you've created something like, you know, a little video that gives you what we just saw Ian do, create that tale, that published tale, if that's something that would be, could be put on the clearinghouse, that people want to refer to that, either as a way to bring it into a learning activity, if they've got a course and they're interested in working with certain kinds of data, or they want to, you know, learn more about these kinds of tools, the world tale tool, or the Globus tool, or, you know, other kinds of things like that. There are ways, you know, a lot of times there are links on web pages to small videos or different kinds of things where you actually have an opportunity as a teacher, as an instructor about data management, to put a link to that in your presentation, into your syllabus, into your course. It's a sort of thing that you can use as a way to both let people know about your service or resource or tool, but also then put up your own resources as well. So I just offer that as an opportunity to contribute, and you know that, and then that idea of the commons is that, you know, it's all available from different disciplines and different ways of approaching the research data management problem. So that's it.
That's awesome.
Yeah. Any questions?
Yeah.